हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट सेकंड ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज दैट वाज रिलेटेड टू टॉपिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। यस्टरडे वी हैव डन द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड ए कंपैरेटिव स्टडी बिटवीन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड अदर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट लाइक वर्सेस प्योर साइंस मैनेजमेंट टेक्निक्स एंड values. We have done a comparative study of all these three aspects. Today we will do the next topic, that is related to nature and features of principles of management. Today we will discuss about the nature and features of principles of management. As yesterday we have done that principles of management are the fundamental truths. Principles of management are the fundamental truth which acts as a guideline for managerial actions and decisions. Principles of management act as a guideline. So today we will start our next topic, nature of principles of management. So there are many points. On the basis of these points we will understood the features or nature of principle of management. So let's start with first point. There is a first point related to nature of the principle of management, that is universal application. This feature says that principles of management are universal applicable, means these can be applied anywhere. Anywhere means it can be applied in small organizations or in large organization. These can be applied anywhere, in small size organization or large size organization, or anywhere we can apply the principles as per our requirement. And these are universally applicable. For example, there is a principle of management. Yesterday also I have told you about this principle of management, that division of work or division of labor. This principle of management can be applied or used by small organization or large organization or middle organization, because it will provide the benefit of specialization. Because the division of work will provide the benefit of specialization and it will give the more efficient results. Division of work will provide the more efficient work. Yesterday we took the example of school also, that in school also there is division of work. So principles of management are universal applicable. We can apply principle of management anywhere as per our requirement, and these provides benefit. These provide, keep in mind that these provide general guidelines only. Okay, we have clear, we have completed first point of nature, that principles of management are universal applicable. Second is related to general guideline. Yesterday also we done this topic about general guideline, that principle of management are guidelines for the managerial actions. Principle of management are the guidelines. These are not the direct result. Here we will took an example of principle of management, that there is one principle of management related to fair remuneration. There is a principle of management given by Henry Fayol, that is fair remuneration. Fair remuneration means there should be adequate salary to the employees for their work done. What is fair remuneration? That there must be an adequate salary for the employees for the work done. This principle of management gives the guideline of fair remuneration. It doesn't say how much salary. It doesn't say the exact amount which is to be given. Fair remuneration, we can took here also an example of there is a large company and there is small scale company. Large scale, for the large scale company, the fair remuneration can be 50,000 per month. For the large scale company, fair remuneration can be 50,000 per month. But for the small scale industry or small scale organization, 5,000 can be the fair remuneration. Here, the principle of management says that that the every worker should get the fair remuneration. This is just a guideline. It doesn't say that this amount is to be given as a remuneration. It doesn't say that 50,000, 60,000 or 5,000, 10,000. It doesn't fix the amount which is to be given as fair remuneration. It says that there should be adequate salary for the work done. And here we took an example that a large scale company can give 50,000 per month as a salary to the its workers, and a small scale company can give only 5,000 per month as a remuneration to their workers. So general guideline says that principle of management are just guidelines. These are providing guidelines for the organization that how to work. It doesn't provide the result. So have you got this point? Now we will move to next point, formed by practice and experiments. There is one next point that principles of management are formed by practice and experiments. These are not directly given. These are deeply observed. Principles of management are deeply observed. Then they are applied in an organization. We took an example of division of labor. We say that their principle of management says that there should be division of work. Or there is one more principle of management. I have told you that Henry Ford has given the 14 principles of management. We will discuss after these points. First of all, we will discuss the nature, and then we will discuss the importance of principle management. Then we will start the principles given by Henry Ford and F.W. Taylor. So there is one principle of management given by Henry Ford, division of work. There is one more principle of management which says order. Principle of order. There are many principles. I have told you 14 principles by Henry Ford. I have taken the example of two principle of management that these are formed by practice. How these division of work says that work should be divided in some part, and principle of order says that every thing should be in a proper order as at a proper place. So this says that if everything will be on a proper order, so if we take an example of library. If we go to our school library and there is nothing in order, if the books are not in order, then we will not come to know that which books are related to GK books, related to commerce section books, art section books, or any other book if we want. If these books are in order and put it in appropriate racks, then we will come to know that if that or like this, there is a library. If we say that it is a library and there are many racks in the library. There are many racks in the library. First rack, it is an Almira of our library. First rack box says that there are GK books. Second is related to commerce books. Third is related to arts books. Fourth is related to science books. This related to comic books. Yeah, many other books are there, and these are put in an appropriate manner. These are put in an appropriate manner, written with a slip of highlighting the section of books. Then it says that it is applied the principle of order that everything is in an appropriate manner. If we will go to library and there is no rack or no proper mention of books, or the books are not in order, then we will not come to know that which book we want to collect, we will not get that. So principle of order, division of work. There are 14 principles developed by Henry Ford, and these principles are formed by practice and experiments. These are principles are applied in many organizations. Then they observed that by applying these principles, the working level or the efficiency level of the workers is increasing, and there is development of specialization in the work, and due to this, there is work is done in an invited or these are not directly applied. Next is flexibility. This point says that principles of management are changeable. Somewhat we can change the principle of management as per the requirement of organization. As per the requirement of organization, the principles of management are flexible. We can make the changes as per the requirement of organization or as per the requirement of environment. Next principle of management says that feature of principle of management. So we are doing features of principle of management. Next feature says that principles of management are behavioral in nature. That these principle of management are focusing on the behavior of the employees who are working in the organization, and these principles are focusing on making the good relationship between the top level, middle level and the supervisory level and with the workforce. There is a principle of management as spirit they talk. There is a principle of management given by Henry Fayol as far as J. Crow. This principle of management says that everyone should work together and towards the common goal. Everyone should work together. हर एक को क्या है मिल के काम करना चाहिए और हर एक का उद्देश्य क्या होना चाहिए ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का गोल. As per the of there is this principle of management focusing the good relationship on the good relationship between the workers of the organization. Next is related to based on cause and effect relationship. The principle of management says that if we does a work, if we put any effort, then it will have an effect. Yesterday also I have cleared you cause and effect relationship, that if we do something, then it will have the effect. It can be positive or negative. If we do something, then it will have the effect positive or negative. And the principle of management are based on cause and effect relationship. Means if we are using any principle, it will have some effect. Like we have used the principle of order, principle of division of work, yeah, or there is a one more principle, unity of direction, unity of command. These principles, if we apply any principle, it will have effect, and mostly we are using the principles for having the good impact. So principle of management are based on cause and effect relationships. Next is related to contingent principle of is also a feature of principle of management. In this it says that principle of management are applied as per the requirement or as per the size of the organization. If we have used any principle of management, it will have effect and it will give any result, and it will be based on the applying manner, how we are applying, and on the size of the organization. So we have completed the nature or features of principle of management. I am revising the points only. First we have done universal application, second general guidelines, third formed by practice and experiments, fourth one was related to flexibility, fifth is behavioral in nature, sixth based on cause and effect relationship, and the seventh was related to contingent. These are the nature or features of the principles of management. So students, we have completed our today's topic, nature or features of principle of management. Revise this topic and yesterday's topic. Tomorrow we will do the importance of principle of management. Do regular studies at your home. बी सेफ, स्टे होम, स्टे हैप्पी. थैंक यू.